This video demonstration will provide a brief overview of the JSON editing support in Oxygen after various improvements were implemented in version 21. The outline view was redesigned to work seamlessly with JSON documents. Major improvements for the outline view include support for all types of JSON constructs, for example, objects, arrays, or simple types. Its functionality is similar to the outline view for XML documents. You can search for a specific JSON property name. The outline view is synchronized with the main editing pane. It now features a more robust internal model that displays the document structure even if the JSON content is not well formed. And when a validation problem is found, an error icon is displayed in the outline tree, allowing you to easily pinpoint the source of the error. You can also hover over the icon to see a tooltip with details about the problem. Another major improvement was the addition of an intelligent content completion assistant that offers proposals for quickly inserting JSON structures that are valid at the current editing location. This feature is schema-driven, and the list of proposals depend on the associated JSON schema. For our example, I already have a JSON schema that defines our JSON document structure. There are two ways to associate a JSON schema to a JSON document. You can create a validation scenario that binds the JSON schema with the current document. Here, I need to specify the URL of the JSON schema in the validation scenario. Another method is to associate the JSON schema directly in the document by using the Associate Schema action that is available on the toolbar. Notice that the schema property was added at the beginning of the document with its values set to the specified URL. Note that if both types of schema association are used for a document, the schema defined in the validation scenario has a higher priority and will be used by the validation engine, content completion, and for other actions such as go to definition. To quickly access the schema associated with the current document, you can select the Open Associated Schema action from the toolbar. The properties and values that can be inserted in a specific context are presented automatically as you are editing the JSON document. To show how this works, I'll insert properties for a new person. The Content Completion Assistant can be triggered in a valid location within JSON documents by pressing Ctrl Space, or the Enter key, or a double quote character. As I'm inserting these properties and values, I'm invoking the Content Completion Assistant by pressing Enter. Note that Oxygen displays documentation for each proposal in a small window to the right of the Content Completion window. This information is collected from the associated JSON schema. I can right-click a property and select Go to Definition to open the schema where that property is defined. Proposing valid code constructs at the current editing location makes it easier and faster to edit JSON documents and keep them well-formed. The Content Completion Assistant also includes built-in JSON code templates to help you insert bigger JSON code fragments. You can press Ctrl, Shift, and Space to see a complete list of the available code templates. You can also define your own code templates. As an example, I'll create a code template based upon the whole person fragment that I just added, where I inserted the properties one by one. This will speed up the process of adding a new person definition in the future. To create a code template, I'll copy an existing person fragment, then I'll open the Preferences dialog and look for the Code Templates Preferences page. Now I click New to create a fresh code template. Some of the fields are optional, but I need to enter a name for the code template, specify the editor type, and then in the content area, I can paste the copied fragment. I'll edit the fragment and keep only the relevant information. Then I click OK to save my changes. To enter the code template in my document, I place the cursor at a valid location and press Ctrl+Shift+Space to invoke the content completion list. The new code template is now available in the list of proposals. Now I select the appropriate template and press Enter. And I use the format and indent action to make the document look better. Now I can continue to input information in the inserted fragment. And this concludes the demonstration. As always, thanks for watching.